Hi, my name is Thomas Foster, and this is the second part of a multi-part tutorial on GarageBand from Apple. In this tutorial, we will take a closer look how to work with audio tracks, how to loop audio, how to cut audio, and how to make some effects on it. So have fun. We take again an empty project, let's say choose. And now GarageBand asks us if we want to use a MIDI track called Software Instrument or an audio track. Let's choose an audio track, the first one with a microphone here. I say create. And now we have an audio track here. There are so many open windows. Let's close them. This here is the library. We close it by clicking the first button here. Here are the smart controls. It's the third button. We close this also. All right. Now we want to have not just one audio track. We want to have four or five audio tracks. We could use this plus symbol here to repeat the step to create an audio track. But there's a simpler way. We select the track and we use the key command, command D, D like Dora, to duplicate it, or D like duplicate, right? We do this again and again and again, and now we have five audio tracks. Good. Now we need some audio tracks to import. We can download them for free. You can download them for free. A homepage called Mutant. If you don't know Mutant.com, that's an amazing project I'm involved in. That's a platform for audio files, loops, drum beats, and whatever. And many of them are free, so you can download them for free. You don't have to log in or something. It's very easy. For example, we search for Conga, and immediately you see the search results. You can listen to them. And if you like it, you just click on free download, and immediately it goes into your download folder. Beside this text field, you can use this pull-down menus here. So if we search for beat, immediately we have some cool beats here. You can combine them and say, I want another genre. I would like to have a hip-hop beat, right? And immediately you have the typical hip-hop hi-hat. You have a top loop. And many other things. But we want to use a special menu called group. So let's go back here on the genre menu. I click on genre. Here click on instrument to erase our search field again. And here we have the group menu. And every group has a color, for example, green, a tempo, and a key. So green is in the tempo 102 beats per minute, and it's in F minor. And all the chords of the green audio files are also the same. So everything fits together. So it's a lot of fun to work with them. We go to pink, 180 BPM and G minor. And now we use the instrument menu to say we want to have a beat, a pink beat. Let's listen to the first one. Yeah, sounds great. Let's download this. We need a bass. Let's listen to some basses. Well, maybe a little bit too aggressive. Maybe we go, for example, to the deep bass or the pink house bass. Oh, I like this. Let's download this. So I already downloaded some audio files. They were all in the downloads folder, and from there I moved it to a new folder that I called Mutant Pink, so I remember where they're coming from. And every audio file has the tempo in it, so we know exactly the tempo of our audio files. It's 118 BPM. So let's go here to 118 BPM. So now the tempo of our song is also 180 BPM. Let's start with the beat. I think the pink deep house beat is nice. If you want to have exactly this beat here, just search in Mutant for Pink Deep House Bass and you will get exactly this one. So we move it to the beginning on the first track on bar one. Let's make a loop. So we click in the right upper corner and move it to the right. 8 bars more. So we are going now from 1 to 17. Let's listen to this. Here at the end, we have a break. That's great that in Mutual Ensembles, you very often have a break at the end of 8 bars. That makes fun. So let's add a bass after the break, means after 8 bars. Here the pink house bass, maybe. Let's listen to this. Sounds very cool. If you don't hear this, maybe you're listening on too small speakers because this is house music. It's really a very deep bass. And I want to have a harmony instrument. Maybe we use the pink house chords. Let's listen to this. So we already have a problem now. It's getting red here. If you look here, we have a lot of red lights here. We don't like this because too much red light means distortion. So we go back with the level of the beat to -4 dB. The bass, maybe same level. The mix was good, so we also take -4. The chords was too loud for me. Let's go to -8 and listen again. Oh, -7 maybe is okay. That's fine. Now we want to add a melody. Let's use pink pluck. Pink pluck. So it sounds like this. It's also too loud. Let's go to -8. Maybe -10. I like it, but it's too cheesy. It sounds a little bit old-fashioned, like in a crimi or something, old movie. So let's reduce it a little bit, because in a cool house track, the melody is very reduced. So we have 4 phrases. Bam, 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 bam. Maybe we reduce it to phrase 1 and 3. Listen again. That's fine. I want to erase this one here. This one is fine again, and I want to erase this one as well. So if you want to make a cut in an audio file, you have to move the cursor to the position where you want to have the cut. So we go exactly to bar 11. There is the beginning of the second phrase. And now we right click or control click on this region and use the feature split at playhead. You can also remember the key command, command T. That's a little bit faster. All right. And now we click in the left corner of this region and move it to the beginning of the second phrase. To erase the phrase number 4, we can scroll to the ending and move it to here. Or we place the cursor here and use again command T to make a separate file, and now with the backspace key, we can erase it. Let's listen to this. For me, still too much melody. I take now both and move it to the left to erase the last 2 notes. Now it's very short. And also here, much better. Maybe you don't like the very spontaneous ending, but we can use an effect to make this sounding much better. For this, we open the smart controls. You also can do this with the letter B on your keyboard, B like Berta. And you already saw in the last tutorial here this Equalizer and the Sense. But now we want to go a little bit deeper, because here, if you scroll down, we have the plugins. And you can click on this arrow to open the plugins. And now you see all the plugins you have on your channels. And you see we have already two plugins, the compressor, but the compressor is turned off. To turn it on, you would click this button here on the left, turn on, turn off. Also here, the second plugin is already turned on, but it's an equalizer and nothing is happening here. So nothing is changing our sound. Here we could shape the sound a little bit to push some frequencies or to bring the volume of some frequencies down. But we go a little bit deeper in a later tutorial. So we turn it off again and close it again. And now we want to make a third plugin by clicking here at the third slot. If you scroll down, you see here the delays. And we go to the tape delay. In this menu, delay, you find the tape delay. I click on it. And now it's opening the tape delay. To hear better what we do, I use the solo feature, that's the second button here on my melody track. Now, this is yellow and the other ones are gray. That means you're just listening to this melody track. I make a little circle here so I can start it a little faster. I don't want to hear the metronome, so I click on it to turn it off. So, and I do something that you don't have to do. I make my melody much shorter. For this, I zoom in a little bit. I just want to hear the first note. Let's turn the plugin off. So we have just one note now. So we hear much better what the delay is doing. Now you hear the delay in quarters. Here it says 1/4. This is a quarter. How long you hear the delay, you say with the feedback. Here, the third line is the feedback. It's now in 16%. If you turn it off, it's just repeating one time. And that's it. Or you can turn it until 90%. Yeah, that's what we want to do. Go to 90%. And now we use a filter to shape the sound a little bit. Here, low cut is now on 20 hertz. The high cut is on 20,000 hertz, means 20 kilohertz. Let's go up with the low cut to 500 or 600 and down to 3,000 or 4,000 with the high cut. Now you hear the sound, maybe go a little bit more up and down, is a little bit sounding different. We can make it louder. With the wet, you can say how loud you want to hear the effect. 0% is no effect. And 100% is extremely loud. So let's go to 60. Or 50. That's good. So now I go back to the full length of our melody. We go out of the solo mode again by clicking again on this second button. And now we hear again everything. And now we listen. That's much cooler. I like it very much. Let's close the smart edits and smart controls, and we zoom out a little bit here to see everything. We can feature the melody a little bit more. Let's go with the melody 8 bars later, right? Let's repeat the chords and the bass here, and also the bass. But we do not repeat the drums, because we want to feature the melody a little bit more. So give out the drums here. That's very nice. Let's zoom out a little bit. Here is the end of the song at bar 33, I think. Let's make the song a little bit longer by clicking here where it says end marker. and move the marker a little bit to the right so we have more space to work on our song. After this melody part, I want to have again the bass. I want to have again the chords and the bass. And I want to repeat the melody here at the repeating of our full part. Let's listen to this. Please write me in the comments if this video helped you or if you have any questions about this tutorial or GarageBand. My name is Thomas Foster and this is my YouTube or Facebook channel Thomas Foster Music Production, which is all about music production. Here you will find tutorials on the most important DAWs or music programs, the most important plugins, and I'll show you how to produce the current sound of the charts and the clubs. If you have any questions about this video or more generally about music production, just write me in the comments. I'll answer all your questions. Of course, I'm also happy about a simple feedback or suggestion for another video. Do not forget to subscribe to my channel to not miss any of my videos. At this point, I say thank you for being there. Always stay creative. Cheers!